This is how the house was when I got it. Then I did this. Then I just did this. Overall, I'm really, really happy with that.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I have another project I want to do, and it's another lighting video. So a couple years when I moved into the house, this garage space was really dark, really dim. I did a video about these light fixtures and added them, made the garage way brighter. Since then, I finished painting, changed the floor up a bit. I was gonna do epoxy, but actually decided to do racetrack instead. The main reasons I did the racetrack was because if you actually work on your vehicles, you work in the garage, epoxy actually doesn't really hold up. You have to refinish it every few years. This is actually a little bit more expensive to do than the epoxy quotes I got, but I've used jacks on certain spots, damaged those squares, and just swapped them out with extras that I had, which made working on it way easier. It is a little bit louder. Also, if slash when I move, I can pick it up and take it with me, and the garage floor is bare, so that's a huge plus. Since that video came out, they actually came out with these new fixtures, which I actually installed like last week. They're okay. They are fairly bright. Only problem that I've been having is because I have this huge beam you can see behind me, is I actually gotta clean some cobwebs. This corner in the back of the garage is really dark, so already did get extensions for them to drop them down. So that one's actually lower, that one's higher, and it made really no difference whatsoever. Working on the back of the car or just lighting in general, this part of the garage is pretty dark. So what I want to do is add some lighting to this beam. So obviously there is no light fixtures here. That means adding a light. And I started doing some Googling, some YouTubing, and came across the Harbor Freight Braun series light. So Harbor Freight has these two different lights. One is like a 10,000 lumen light. The other one is a 5,500 lumen light, which is what I got. I think they're only or less than 20 bucks a piece. So I ended up getting four of them. And the idea is to link all of them together along that bar. They are linkable up to eight. I'm gonna just do four, might add five later depending on the length, but four will be fine. I don't need it all the way to the edge. Now, the one thing I don't like about these is the way they mount. They mount using a hook system, which would hang down, which I don't like. That would defeat the purpose of adding lights higher. I wanna flush mount them, and I'm gonna show you a really cool solution that I found. And I was not able to find any videos about it, so that's why we're doing this. But each one has a chain that you would have to pull to turn on. And if you've got a garage space or a basement or something like that, I'm not gonna be able to go yoink, 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 yoink. That's just really not handy or a good solution. So I'm gonna show you what solution I found or kind of figured out and what we're gonna do today. All right, so this is the one light I've been testing with. Here's the chain. This is how you have to turn them on. But if these are all on and they're linked and you have a power source, you can turn all of them on or off. So what I'm gonna do is, I found a remote control outlet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to mount, plug into that socket there next to the garage door opener. We're gonna run the white extension cable down and around, key clamp them so they stay flush. I want it to be really flush and clean. I also want it to stay white and neat, unlike my overspray on that. Don't mind that. But I want it to stay nice and clean and look kind of like it was meant to be there. That brings me to these guys. These are 3D printed clamps that go on the end. And now these will bolt right to the ceiling. They were black, as you can kind of see. And I painted them white because I want them to be white. I'm actually gonna paint all the ends of these as well. These will sit flush and mount this directly to the ceiling. Way easier to keep them next to each other. There's no really good provisions on these to mount. Those are for the hooks, and that's pretty much it. So this was the best thing I found for keeping it flush. Also, the lower you hang it, these little fins are gonna prevent light from going every which way. It's gonna kind of keep it spotlight. So I really wanted to go as high as possible with those. We got eight of them, pair for each, and P-clamps. So those will keep the wire nice and tight next to the ceiling to keep it looking factory. So the cool thing about this guy is that plug will go up top
and then that little switch I can mount anywhere. It has a battery in it, so I can put it next to my actual light switch.
I could put it next to it, but I really don't want the white. Maybe I'll put it over there, actually. That's not a bad idea. I'll put it over there. So normal light, and then I will put the spare light over there. People said in the comments before, oh, the black makes it darker. Yeah, I don't care. That's not the point. I want a black wall. I think it looks great, but you do you. I gotta move the car. We'll get started.
All right, now that the car's out, we had to shut the door kind of so we could work in that space, otherwise the garage would shut it. That brings me to my next point. I would love to do a lift in here, a low profile one, because I do have the ceiling height. I think we have either 10 or 12 foot ceilings in here. The problem is I'd have to completely change up how the garage is, because as soon as you lift the car up, it's gonna hit that sort of thing. So if anybody has any great solutions other than the quick jacks, I'm not really a big fan. I mean, they're cool, but not really for what I want. I wanna be able to literally get under it pretty well. So project for another day.
That's basically just gonna go into the outlet, and the trigger light is what turns that on. And as long as all of these are on, that turning it on should turn on the whole strip, which is great. So I don't have to, which is really stupid.
So we've got it P-clamped on. I could probably wipe this down, it's a little dirty, but wire running down nice and clean. I mean, you're close up, you can't really, you can tell, but from the bottom, I think it'll look good. View from down here. The only thing I'm not gonna do, only until I get everything mounted, I might do it later, is cut and trim these shorter, so they're not so long. I am gonna paint them, but they do plug into each other, so I really don't need a long cable. The problem is you literally have to cut, splice, solder, and I don't really wanna do all of that in case I extend them, at least for now. All right, I have all of these taped up. I trimmed the strings, so there's a little bit I can turn them on, but they'll pretty much hide away if I really want them to. Taped off the ends, and we're gonna just hit those with a little bit of paint. First coat, we'll hit it again later, but probably don't need to show all that. All right, while the light's dry, I did some quick redneck measuring. I think I wanna do it as far that way as possible and as tight as possible, only if there is enough room. I'd rather have all the lighting on this side. This is where I do most of the work on the car. I wanna light up obviously the whole garage, but if there is room for another one, I'll try to squeeze it in or figure out a solution to make it one full strip versus spacing it and having a gap in between. I just think that's more of what I want to do.
So the one thing I just noticed about these, obviously I painted them, but you'll notice this is on the outs, this is on technically on the inside. So one of them is going to be mounted on the inside of this, and then the other will be mounted on the outside. See where that stops? Ideally, I would like to have just outsides. I think that makes it installing easier. See how it stops. So technically the thing stops here. So this one has to be the first one in the succession of each line so that you're able to bolt it in, put the light in, cap it off, and then screw the second one in. Because if you had the light in on that one, it would be really hard to slip this over and mount it into the fixture.
All right, I have the first one mounted. I have the line running down still, only because what I think I'm gonna do is I think I'm going to hide the excess cable on this side. So I wanna make sure I get everything plugged in before I start P-clamping the remainder. So I wanna get one in, test it, test out the method, and then we'll go from there. 3D print cracked on that side. Oh, I like that. That's gonna be nice. Let's turn this off. Yeah, because I think two next to each other, there'll be a little bit of a gap. And then another two. That's a good amount of light. And the cool part is it's along this wall. You can see the pattern. It's actually coming out a lot. So
let's do the rest.
Important to note, you have to thread these in first. So just giving you a heads up. Makes it a little bit more tricky, but if you want them to be flush and close together, put that in, hold it, mount it, slide it in. Figure out what you're gonna do with the wire later. All right, we have all four done right now. Honestly, I'm pretty happy with it. It looks really good. The only thing I need to finish up doing is hiding the wires, the little wire management, but overall I'm pretty happy with it. Nice lighting over here. There is still a little bit of a gap, but honestly, and another 4 foot's not gonna fit, but I'm honestly not that worried about it. Light is mainly where I want it. It might bother some. Some people might wanna space them a little bit differently, but dude, I'm super happy with that. It's harder to tell the difference on the camera, especially with the garage door open. Oh yeah, way better. That looks awesome. Dude, that looks great. I really like that. And then to have our own switch here that I can just mount on the wall, have a separate one. All right, I finished getting the wiring up out of the way. Made it look super clean. I am really happy with that. That looks awesome. Now, I know a lot of you are probably like, oh, why don't you put those hexagon things in? They're cool. It's not really a showroom. I don't do any detailing or anything in here. I want it more of a workspace. So maybe I'll add some more lights along here now that this section is now the brightest. But overall, I mean, let's see. That's probably as close to what it looks like for my eye. If I turn these off, yeah, I mean, that is where the majority of the lighting is coming from now. Whereas before, it was just this. Yeah, before it was just this. Now,
on,
on, off. What do you think, bud? You like it? Magnetic, this comes off of here, so you can take that off, and then you mount this plate, which is really cool. But I used to think this was bright. This is how the house was when I got it. Then I did this, then I just did this. So, way better, usable workspace. Now I kinda want more, is that bad? The only thing I did notice is these do get very warm. I was just up there with them on, and I was sweating. It is, they definitely get warm. Overall, I'm really, really happy with that. I'll give you an idea of how bright this is. My phone's probably gonna adjust, but this gives you a pretty good idea. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time.